Aloha, everybody, and welcome back to part 5 of Rumble Roses. We are now going through the game with the pop singer Aisha, as picked by my co-com Caro.
Yes. I already love her already because she loves potato chips. I love me some potato chips, too.
She'll eat the whole bag.
Yes. I eat the whole bag. She's so relatable already.
I used to eat whole bags of chips, but unfortunately that gives you a lot of calories, and I just don't work out enough, so...
Not if you eat the baked Lay's type. I don't know if they have baked Lay's in Canada.
It doesn't ring a bell.
Okay, it's probably an American thing then.
I was born in Atlanta, Georgia.
Hey! Oh my god, she was born in Atlanta! That's my hometown! I love her a lot already! She's great!
Right now, all I can think about is my next album.
What do you do in a typical day?
It's been pretty boring lately. When I have some time off, I go to my vacation home in Nice. I'm also into scuba.
Ladies have these very interesting activities. Oh, she's my age! Oh my gosh! She is literally me! Except I'm not a wrestler, I'm not that athletic.
No matter how many world tours I do or how famous I get, I can never reach the top. I can't get satisfaction.
Oh.
Wherever I turn, Dixie Clemets. Even after busting my ass all these years and thinking I finally made it, she sweeps in and knocks me down. I never get satisfaction until I have her smiling face under my boot.
Oh.
I'm coming for you, cowgirl.
Hell yeah.
Simming in on her ass again.
The game can't help itself. That's just the default camera angle. I don't know.
Oh, does she, like, sing her own theme song?
She might be. Yeah, actually. It said Aisha on the bottom right. Yeah, apparently she sings her own theme song. She is a pop diva, after all, so she has backup dancers, and she moves like Britney Spears, because of course she does.
Mm-hmm. This is very, very 2000s.
Oh, yeah.
Like, the whole pop star craze in the 2000s is, like, a thing of, like, teen pop.
I miss it. Yeah, I said it. I miss it.
I miss it, too. It's so hokey.
It's so cheesy and dumb, but you know what? I loved going onto the radio in the late 90s, early 2000s, and then there's NSYNC blaring.
Wait, were you NSYNC or Backstreet Boys?
My mom loved Backstreet Boys, so I have to say Backstreet Boys.
Yes! I am also a Backstreet Boys girl.
She would always be sitting on the couch listening to Backstreet's
Back. Alright! Dee-dee-dee. I played their CDs on, like, my really bulk. You remember those CD players that you could carry around?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Oh, my gosh. Such a long time ago.
And I got nothing against NSYNC because, you know, it's got Lance Bass, and Lance Bass is the OG Sephiroth. I can't hate that.
I can't either because, like, imagine Sephiroth just dancing to, like, music before he kills off Aerith. So. He's like, bye, 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 bye.
My favorite thing about Lance Bass's Twitter is that on his bio, he specifically states that he is the OG Sephiroth because he was the first voice actor to ever play the role of Sephiroth in anything.
Right.
Because, of course, the original Final Fantasy VII didn't have voice acting, but when he joined Kingdom Hearts, that he was the first.
Mm-hmm.
So that's fun.
That is neat.
Anyway, folks, this is Aisha, and Aisha is basically the submission wrestler, I would say, because every single one of her specials, her killer move, her lethal move, her humiliation move, they are all submissions. Despite me trying to give Aigle a broken nose right now, it ends with the arm submission, so she's Ronda Rousey.
She's literally Ronda Rousey. Or Becky Lynch's disarm her.
Yeah, yeah. Now, her killer move works on the legs, her lethal move works on the arms, and then her humiliation move also works on the legs. The thing is, she doesn't have a lot of leg-centric attacks, so Well, for that matter, she doesn't have a lot of arm-centric attacks either, so you're just gonna have to, like, do them over and over again until you wear them down, like I am here with Eigel.
Yeah, beat that bitch up.
Tap, Nomad, tap!
Yes, give up!
Hey there, Aisha.
Dixie?
What you doing here?
What do you think I'm doing here, fool? I've canceled my tour just so I could come kick your ass.
Still bitter? Well, sorry there, gal, but you're not the one I came to fight.
Then who?
Reiko, a little samurai come all the way over from Japan.
Hey! Don't walk away while I'm talking to you!
Not every Japanese person is a samurai, Dixie.
Oh my god.
Juan Wayne is going down.
Juan Wayne?
Yeah, it's like supposed to be like John Wayne.
Okay.
Hey, you're Aisha, aren't ya? No big deal in person.
Didn't anyone teach you manners? You were sitting on my last nerve.
I've been in 3 mud wrestling matches this whole playthrough.
Just a typical rich diva thinking she can push me around with her money.
I was poor like you once, so you best think about who you're messing with.
History lesson over? I'm more interested in the now and down, old lady.
Oh, with the history diss.
When you're in your early 20s, you're an old lady. Sorry, Caro.
No! Well, you're old. No, I don't care.
Nuh-uh.
Uh-huh. Yes, you are.
Just because I grew up with the NES doesn't mean that I'm old, okay?
That does mean that you're old. Did you play video games in black and white?
That's right, and it was called Pong.
It's Pong.
Respect the legacy. Respect. So yeah, here I am working on the legs. Like, every time you push down in circle, or is it down in triangle? Either way, when you push down and the grab button, you will always default to knocking them on the ground and then attaching to their legs. And then you can kick their legs and then do grabs to their legs. And so I'm going to be working on Candy Canes so that I can do the humiliation move to her. Even though I'm doing a lethal move, I was actually trying to do a killer move, but I forgot that, like, when you counter people, they're kind of in the stun state so that you can do the lethal finisher. And I was like, shit! I don't want to work on her arms!
Oh, right.
I love how Aisha's drowning herself just to apply that submission.
Well, you gotta do anything you can to just submit her. This is a chocolate milk fight, after all.
Oh yeah, she's thirsty, never mind.
Yeah, they're all thirsty. Everyone in this game is thirsty.
The audience is thirsty, the characters are thirsty.
Lady X is thirsty.
Oh yeah. This game just exudes thirst. Also, for this playthrough, because Aisha is so submission-centric, these matches ended up going a lot longer than I wanted them to. So I figured for the rest of this playthrough, I would be cutting out at least 2 more matches. I'm going to keep the first 2 for every girl, and I'm going to keep their fight with their main rival. So for example, Aisha wants to go after Dixie Clemets, then I'm going to be keeping that fight in.
Right.
And I'm also going to keep the fight with Lady X, because that's the final battle, and, you know, I want to prove that I've beaten this. And,
sure you do.
I'm a pro gamer and I gotta prove it.
I don't believe you.
I didn't steal this footage from someone else. I didn't bring my cousin over and tell him to beat the game for me. That'd be stupid.
Going off those pro gamer strats is hard. Very hard.
You're not going to be reading in the news that there's this big scandal. The great Clement faked all of his playthroughs. His cousin played all of them.
Hashtag ClementJ64 is over party. I'm going to trend it.
Ah, shit.
You're done. Canceled.
Got your nose.
Ow!
Go! make you feel shame!
Oh my god. Are they, like, drowning? How are they breathing? Because it looks like their faces are fully submerged in
Damn.
It.
Yeah.
This swimsuit costs a fortune. Now look at it.
Looks fine to me.
Wonderful! Quite the celebrity. You and that mud would make a great photo shoot.
Ew, it's her.
Who the hell are you? You looking for a fight?
Of course not. I'm Anesthesia, assistant and nurse to Lady X, the CEO. It's a pleasure to meet you.
So apparently Lady X is the CEO of the Rumble Rose Tournament, which it doesn't say that in the instruction manuals or anything. And considering she's a robot who doesn't talk, I don't know how that works.
So they just dropped that, like, she's the CEO?
Yeah.
Oh, by the way, Lady X is the CEO. How did she do stuff? How did she run everything?
I mean, I'm sure she has robot efficiency at her tasks, but still.
Miss Aisha.
Yes?
You are Miss Aisha, correct? My students are all quite big fans of yours. Could I please have your autograph?
Whatever. Who are you?
Oh, my apologies. I am Miss Spencer, and Miss Welsh is in my class. As her teacher, I have come for revenge.
Revenge? Goddamn.
Oh, now I see what's up. Well, bring it on!
You mean, bring it on, Miss Spencer.
Oh, she's Spencer? One of those Excellent. People. He's like, excuse me, it's Miss Spencer.
Oh, yeah. I mean, you haven't seen Miss Spencer's, like, alter ego. Oh my god, her alter ego.
I just checked the schedule. You're off to fight Rago tomorrow, ain't ya?
That's what it says. After tomorrow, I'll be whistling for Dixie. You need to worry about me, not Rago.
Listen, sugar. I have to fight Rago. That's the whole reason I'm here.
There's a picture of you fighting Rago right behind you.
I was gonna say!
You apparently must have fought her before if you took that photo. I don't know why all the, like, promotional material in, like, the stadiums, the arenas, like, even the Titantron, it's just Dixie and Rago fighting each other. I mean, I'm sure it's because that's the box art, like, that's the promotional art they use to advertise the game.
Yeah.
But in-universe, it's just kind of weird that, like, these are the only two stars who are being focused on right now, you know? It's like, I half expect one of the girls to do a CM Punk pipe bomb to be like,
I was just thinking that.
I'm sick of not being promoted, I'm sick of being behind Dixie and Reiko's fucking second fiddle.
You want to hear about the Rumble Roses and the makeup and the, what was it, the Be a Star campaign? Well, Mike muted.
Things won't change until Anesthesia and the rest of her stupid family are dead. Anyway, I beat up Rago.
That was quick, oh my gosh. Alright, here we go. That was a squash match we just watched. Now we're here for the real main offense.
I was wondering, what have I ever done to you?
You always acted like the queen of high school.
The queen of high school? In no that, I don't think so.
I couldn't measure up.
Yeah, but you're a big old star now. Let it go.
You were born rich. You can't understand what it's like for me. No matter how high I go, I'm never gonna be number one.
Oh.
Until I take you down.
All right, Aisha. But I ain't holding back.
I'm at the top of my game. Bring it on, cowgirl!
Bring it on, fox boy!
Oh no. I don't think Tails would last in a wrestling ring.
Well, technically, he has been in a wrestling ring before with the Mario and Sonic Tokyo 2020 boxing match.
Right.
So he could totally dominate in that ring.
And also, I made Sonic and Tails as creator wrestlers in SmackDown vs. Raw, and I put them against DX. I put them against DX and they won. That was the WrestleMania main event in my campaign with Sonic and Tails versus D-Generation X in a TLC match, and they won.
Guess they're gonna have to suck it now.
Oh, God.
Unfortunately, Rumble Rose does not have a create a character system. It only has the girls on display. You can't create your gigantic breasted beauty.
You can't create your big-butted wrestler with assets.
Yeah. God, I want to expand those assets, you know? I should also mention that there is a sequel to Rumble Roses for the Xbox 360. It's called Rumble Roses XX. And I'm not going to do a playthrough of that game, but I am going to show some stuff off of it at the end of this playthrough. The reason I'm not doing a playthrough is because it doesn't have a story mode. It doesn't have cutscenes or dialogue of any kind whatsoever. It doesn't even have a proper arcade mode or anything. It's weird.
Is it just multiplayer then?
It's mostly just multiplayer, and like, you can take on a whole bunch of bots in order to get the trophy and like, earn some achievements. But there's no story mode whatsoever, and you just like, you just fight. That's all you do in it.
Mm-hmm.
The biggest thing that that game adds is tag team matches, because again, in Rumble Roses, it's only one-on-one. It's only 1v1. There's nothing else to it. But in Rumble Roses XX, you can do tag team matches, and the girls actually have combo moves and combo finishers, which are pretty cool. So I might show that off later.
Yeah.
But yeah, I'll show off the entrances and stuff at least for Rumble Roses XX, because those are pretty fun.
Sounds good.
Not bad yourself. Don't start getting mushy. Maybe it's time for me to release a CD and enter the pop music world.
Oh, girl, you sing like a half-assed alley cat. Give it up.
Glad you're enjoying the trash.
Do you own cow pattern clothing? Next
time, do I own cow pattern clothing? No.
Oh. Until then, I expect. Well, I think you should invest in some. Don't
worry about that. I'm Canadian. Most of my clothing is just flannel or.
You do not own flannel. No, you don't.
My pajamas are flannel.
The size of the pajamas. I've never seen you wear flannel.
That's right. I'm not fitting into the stereotype, alright?
So you don't own all those bottles of syrup in your fridge?
I have one bottle of syrup. Just one.
What's your problem? Okay. Alright then.
I don't even play hockey.
Wow! How shocking.
Ta-ta! See you tomorrow.
Ta-ta!
Ta-ta! Ta-ta!
Ah, to think that I can have my way with the most desired body in the world.
Sorry, girl, I'm not into that. Besides, I'm the one that will be running this show.
Well, of course, the evil wrestler's a lesbian. God.
Oh my God. That reminds me of that, Mickey James Trish Stratus storyline.
Oh, like, Jesus.
When Mickey was in WWE and Mickey was stalking Trish, but it turns out that she was legit actually in love with Trish.
Yeah.
And like tried kissing her.
The most memorable thing about their encounter for me was like when they actually fought at WrestleMania.
Yeah.
There is this moment where Mickey James actually grabs Trish Stratus's vagina.
Yeah!
I'm not kidding. That actually happened.
I know! Y'all, for the audience, remember when I told y'all that my first WrestleMania there was a Playboy pillow fight? That match was in that same WrestleMania. My mother also watched that.
Oh no!
So I'm watching this match and I'm like, oh, I love Mickey and Trish, and that spot happens, and I'm so confused because I'm like 9 or 10 when this happens, and I'm like, what just happened? I think that's a no-no. This is like my mother's literal first impression of pro wrestling.
And if you haven't seen it, like, she grabs Trish's vagina.
Yes. It is bad. It is so bad.
And then she extends her fingers into a V formation to lick between them.
Yeah.
Like a sexual deviant. That she is.
Super.
And that actually was a thing in a WrestleMania pay-per-view. Wrestling was certainly something, let me tell you.
Wrestling was weird back then. In that same year, like literally a month later, there was a storyline where Shawn Michaels and God, I kid you not, it's God, fight Vince and the Spirit Squad, or Vince and Shane, whatever. But Vince was like, Shawn is going to team up with God. And yeah, wrestling is great.
They actually demonstrated that by having God come into the ring as a spotlight.
Yeah. Wrestling is weird. It's weird. I love it, but when it's weird, it is weird.
I would share more fun anecdotes about wrestling, but I'm worried WWE might take down my videos. This is the only chance I get to talk about wrestling, because WWE destroyed my WrestleGamia series.
I'm so sad about that, because I love WrestleGamia. I thought it was a cute little series.
Mm-hmm. For those who don't know, back in the day, I did a retrospective on wrestling video games. Stuff from the Super Nintendo all the way to the Xbox 360, which was the most recent thing at the time. And, yeah, a lot of those videos got blocked in every country by WWE. And, yeah, they're just gone, and I'm sorry. I don't have backup copies of a lot of those. Oh, God.
Oh, there she goes.
I don't know why I went back in the ring, but she didn't hurt me, luckily.
Damn, NHB combo.
Tap, Cyborg, tap!
Tap, bitch.
I'll break your goddamn wrist!
Tap. Come on, tap. Tap.
I should also mention that Lady X has an incredibly resistant humiliation state. So, like, you're not likely to do a humiliation KO on Lady X because it takes a lot to embarrass her.
Well, I would assume so because she's a robot.
Yeah.
And probably doesn't feel anything.
I mean, her tits are already out. She doesn't really have any shame.
My god.
And I don't know why Anesthesia designed this robot lady so that her boobs are out, but, you know. Then again, we just established that Anesthesia might be a lesbian, so maybe that's why.
Yeah.
She just appreciates the female form, you know.
The delicate beauty of the female form.
Ho!
Ho! Ho! Ho, 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 green giant.
Here she comes. Let's tag team her. Don't tell me what to do! Ho! Yo! Ah!
Thanks, Dixie.
Didn't I tell you, sugar? I can't have you losing before I have the chance to beat you.
Dang. Getting into this.
Took you long enough to figure that out. Bit slow, ain't ya?
Want to dance to this song again.
This is my favorite ending just because of the final shot.
Oh god. What's the final shot?
This is gonna be home on that wide open range of a mouth.
Bring it on!
Fucking Rocky 3!
Oh my god, they Rocky 3 it?
It's the Eye of the Tiger!
Does this game deserve to parody Rocky 3? I don't know.
I mean, I feel like Rocky 4's storyline is just as crazy as half the stuff that happened in Rumble Roses. I mean, in Rocky 4, Rocky has a robot. He has a butler robot in Rocky 4.
Yeah, that was pretty legit. But I love Rocky 4. I don't want to compare it to this game.
I'm just saying, Rocky 4 is a little out there. It might be a little anime. He climbed a mountain in fucking Siberia to scream out, Drago!
But more importantly, he stopped the Cold War. He's the one who ended the Cold War.
Rocky ended the Cold War, goddammit. He brought America and Russia together. It's amazing. Anyway, folks, come back for part 6. We are going to do Makoto's story mode. So yeah, should be fun.